Bonjour, I'm Robert Fontaine, creator of the Rebel French program. Just as the name implies, I'm a rebel, and I have developed this attitude over the last 40 years because I've seen students frustrated in trying to learn French. And not only are the students frustrated, it's the teachers that are causing the frustration. Now, let me tell you how I developed this new program. When I first started teaching, I had no experience. And I was taught how to teach French. And after a couple of years, one of my colleagues was learning German. And because I like German, I said to him, can you teach me something? And he said, sure. He said, listen, ich möchte einen Kaffee kaufen, bitte. I go, my goodness, the Germans speak fast. And isn't that what we all say when we learn a language? The language is so fast. And the reason we don't understand is because we don't understand the implication of the language. We don't know how it's put together. So what I did at that point is I wrote it out phonetically in English, French, and Spanish. I have a little bit of Spanish from high school. And I said it to my colleague. I said, ich möchte einen Kaffee kaufen, bitte. And he said, oh, you have it. Listen, I didn't have anything. So my wife and I went for a drive that day. We were driving down the road, and I decided I'm going to do some repetitions. So I'm going, ich möchte einen Kaffee kaufen, bitte. Ich möchte, and just as fast as I could possibly go. Because at that time, my thinking was, if I could do at least 50 repetitions in 2 minutes, I would learn that structure. And my wife is looking at me as if I'm crazy. I'm saying this thing. And at one moment, I stopped. And here's what was going on in my mind at that time. And I didn't realize it, but this is what was happening. My brain said to me, you know what? If you would slow it down a little bit, I would understand what you're saying. That is the trick that the mind plays on you. When your mind tells you to slow down, what it's doing is taking that information and throwing it into the garbage, and you never see it again. I said to myself, I'm going to speak even faster. So I'm going, and it didn't matter that it didn't make sense. I'm spitting on the inside of the windshield of my car. And after 2 minutes, I stopped and I said to my wife, listen to me, I am now German. I go, ich möchte einen Kaffee kaufen, bitte. She goes, my goodness, you are. The next morning, I get up and I said to myself, how do I say that again? I go, oh yeah, ich möchte einen Kaffee kaufen, bitte. I repeated it for 2 or 3 days and I let it go because I only did it for fun. That was in 1977. 1989, I happened to be in Munich, Germany, and lo and behold, they speak German. And I only had one sentence. I go to the restaurant the first night, I'm hungry. I open the menu and I go, oh, they don't have any pictures. I don't have vocabulary. I don't know what to say. The waiter is coming over to me and he's got the pad and paper. And at that point, as language students, we become stupid. I said, he's going to talk to me. How stupid is that? Of course he's going to talk to me. He's the waiter. So he said something. But here's one thing I've learned. Pay attention to context. I said, he probably asked me what I wanted to eat. So I looked at this guy, and understand, at that moment, I'm sweating bullets. My stomach is in a knot. I looked him in the eye, and I pointed to the neighbor's table, and I said, ich möchte einen das kaufen, bitte. And he says, danke schön, and he took off. Well, I said, at least one of us is happy. He left. About 15 minutes later, he comes out with the plate. And because I didn't know what I had ordered, I just said, give me one of those. He put it down in front of me, and he said to me, Einer Wiener Schnitzel mit Kartoffelsalat. And I looked at it, and sure enough, it was a Wiener Schnitzel and potato salad. Just as an aside, if ever you go to Germany, order the Wiener Schnitzel and potato salad. It's fantastic. So when he dropped the plate in front of me, I said, Dankeschön. Then he said, Bitteschön. I said, oh, that must mean you're welcome. So I ate it. Wonderful. The next night, I go to a different restaurant. But this time, I'm smart. I give him the international sign for stop. And I say to this waiter, ich möchte einen Wiener Schnitzel mit Kartoffelsalat, bitte. Bitteschön. And he goes, Dankeschön. I was able to live in Munich, Germany for 1 week with one sentence. Isn't that amazing? And it was after 12 years. I had never used it. If you've taken French before, that information is already there. It just needs to be reactivated in the proper way. And I said to myself, imagine what I could have done if I had had two things to say. So this is what prompted me to create my Rebel French program, to help people to get to that point, so that when you learn things, you learn them once. And now I don't do 50 repetitions. I have you do 15 repetitions in the course of a day, and I'll show you how to make it stick. So if that excites you, keep watching for our videos. Au revoir, à la prochaine.